Yes, ashimwe.
Praise Jesus.
Nagira ngo batuzane ijambo ry'Imana riri muri Malaki gatatu.
So I'm going to read the word of God written in Malachi chapter 3.
Malaki ni igitabo cya nyuma cya Ancien Testament cyangwa isezerano rya kera.
Malachi is the last book in the Old Testament.
Ngiye gusoma mu Kinyarwanda, Moses arasoma mu Cyongereza hanyuma dusenge.
So we'll read in Kinyarwanda and then English before we pray.
Maze abubahaga uwiteka baraganiraga uwiteka gatega matwi akumva nuko igitabo kikandikirwa imbere cy'urwibutso urwibutso rwande rwabubahaga uwiteka bakita ku izina rye uwiteka nyiringa baravuga ati bazaba banjye umunsi nzakoreraho bazaba amatungo yanjye bwite nzabababarira nkuko umuntu ababarira umwana we umukorera ubwo nibwo muzagaruka mukamenya gutandukanya abakiranutsi n'abanyabyaha abakorera Imana n'abatayikorera dore hazaba umunsi utwika nk'itanura ry'umuriro abibone bose n'inkozi z'ibi zose bazaba ibishingwe maze haba umunsi uzabatwika abashiri ni kuwitekanye ngabavuga ntuzabasigira umuzi cyangwa ishami ariko mwebweho abubaha izina ryanjye izuba ryo gukiranuka rizabarasira rifite gukiza mu mababa yaryo maze muzasoka mukinagire nk'inyana zo mu kiraro kandi muzaribatira abanyabyaha hasi bazaba ivu munsi ibirenge byanyu ku munsi nzabikoreraho ni ku Uwiteka nyiringa bavuga mu nyemerere nongereho 23
so allow me to add 23
dore nzaboherereza umuhanuzi Eliya umunsi w'Uwiteka ukomeye kandi uteye ubwo butaragira uwo niwe uzasanganya imitima y'abana n'iyabase iyo ni 24 kugira ngo ntazaza kurimbuza isi umuvumo mwakire neza ijambo ry'Imana.
So let's read in Malachi. Then those who feared the Lord spoke to one another, and the Lord listened and heard him. So a book of remembrance was written before him for those who feared the Lord and who meditate on his name. They shall be mine, says the Lord of hosts, on the day that I make them my jewels. And I will spare them as a man spares his own son who serves him. Then you shall again discern between the righteous and the wicked, between who serves God and the one who does not serve him. For behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, and all the proud, yes, all who do wickedly, will be stubble. And the day which is coming shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts, that will leave them neither root nor branch. But to you who fear the name of the Son of righteousness shall of the Son of righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings, and shall go out and grow fat like store-fed calves. But you shall trample the wicked, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet on the day I, the Lord, say the Lord of hosts. Now let's go to verse 5 and chapter 4. Behold, I'll send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And he'll turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the hearts of the children to their fathers. Lest I come, I strike the earth with a curse.
Manadata mizina ry'umucunguzi wacu Yesu Kristo umukiza umwami turi imbere yawe duciye bugufi uyu ni umwanya wongeye kuturemera ngo utwubake inzira nziza inzira zawe uduha ubwenge bwawe uduha amahoro yawe uduha umugisha wawe mwami uyu ni wa mwanya umugisha wawe tuwakirira mu ijambo uyu ni wa mwanya wavuze ngo ijambo nababwiye ngo ni esprit et vie ni umwuka kandi n'ubuzima mwami wanjye mu izina rya Yesu ndagusaba ngo amagambo yanjye nawe ni amagambo nyine mwami agira imbaraga iyo wowe uyahinduye umwuka nyemerera uyahindura umwuka mu buzima bwacu ye kuba inyuguti yica ye kuba amagambo nk'amagambo ye kuba igitabo gisomwa ye kuba inkuru ahinduka ubuzima mana ndagusaba ngo umwanya nk'uyu he kugira ubuta umuntu yaje aturuka mu rugo arushye avunika mwami reka buri muntu wese ufungura ikiganza cyawe umugenere ifunguro rimukwiriye ndakwizeye nizeye gukora kwawe nizeye kungirira neza na Moses kwatugirira neza tukikizanya n'abatwumva duciye bugufi twemeye gukora kwawe mwuka wera ngaho ngwino bikore ni mu izina rya Yesu mbisabye nizeye amen
Yesu ashimwe Praise Jesus
tumaze iminsi itandatu uyu wa karindwi
so we spent 6 days today is the 7th
twahamagaje amasengesho y'iminsi irindwi
we called for prayers for 7 days
ibi ndabibwira abashyitsi
I'm announcing this to the visitors
ndabibwira n'utarabimenye waje muri twe
and even the one who didn't know this who has joined us
imana yadushyize ku mutima ngo nitumare iminsi tuyikoreza urugendo rw'umwaka
So God laid on our hearts so that we commit this journey of the year to Him. The same way you are seated here today,
online,
and even those who are following us online, you need God to lead your lives on a daily basis. So things just don't come anyhowly. For a Christian, things don't just happen by accident, but they are done in heaven. And then they come down to reach to us. So there are things that we created together with God. Because in prayers we are able to make things.
Yes,
Praise Jesus indeed. So for those who were present, we had a great time. For the one who had a privilege to be there, we had a great time. And the times that enabled us not to be surprised in the course of this year. So I encourage you to look to ask for the message so that you can follow everything that was spoken. So that you can also walk in this year having a clear direction. So in the bottom of my heart today, and in these days of prayer, so the word, the kingdom of God came often. The word God's kingdom came in my heart so often. And even today, you're also going to talk about walking with God. But I want you to retain those two words. Because what we speak becomes from where we have received the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. Allow me to walk with you.
Yes,
Praise Jesus indeed. So I want us to walk together when you have understood something. My desire is not to be surprised by the blessing, for example, in May. Or even in October.
Sinkwifuriza no gutungurwa n'ikibazo utazi icyo ari cyo cyo mu kwezi kwa karindwi.
Oh, be surprised by a problem in the course of July.
Usenze.
So when you pray,
ukabiha Imana,
and you commit it to God,
itangira kugendana nawe.
It starts to work with you.
Ukahagera umwuka wera kubwira uko byitwara.
And actually when you reach there, the Holy Spirit guides you on how you're supposed to go.
Vuga ngo amen.
Please say
yes,
amen.
Ashim.
Praise Jesus.
Mbasomeye rero igitabo cya Malaki mu mpera zacyo.
So we have read the last passage of the book of Malachi.
Biraturukaye.
Where does it come from?
Umwuka muri je aravuga iki?
What is the Holy Spirit saying in me?
Yantumye kubabwira iki?
And what did he send me to tell you?
Malaki ni umuhanuzi wa nyuma w'umwisezerano rya kera.
Malachi is the last prophet in the Old Testament.
Tutirengagije ko abanziriza Yohana umubatiza wafashe hombi.
Knowing that he came before John the Baptist, who was part of the Old Testament and the New Testament.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise Jesus.
Izina Malaki rivuga intumwa y'Imana.
So Malachi means a messenger of God.
Ubwaryo izina rivuga intumwa y'Imana.
So the word Malachi means a messenger of God.
Bikubwira ngo wicaye ugasoma chapitre eshatu kubandi nenye za Malaki wakumva neza umutima w'Imana.
So if you read carefully Malachi chapter 3 and chapter 4, you'll be able to know God's heart.
Malaki rero yahanuye mu kihe gishya.
So when did Malachi prophesy?
Maraki yahanuye mu gihe abayisiraeli bari bavuye muri captivity y'i Babylon.
So he prophesied from the time Israelites had moved from the captivity from Babylon.
Iyo mvuze Israeli ndavuga watoranijwe n'Imana.
When I talk about Israel, I'm talking about the one who's chosen by God.
Bigeze gutwarwa i Babylon.
There's a time they were taken to Babylon.
Baragaruka baza kubaka Yerusalemu.
So they came back to rebuild Jerusalem.
Baza kubaka urusengero.
To build the temple.
Baza kubaka inkike.
And also to build the walls.
Niwumvi background nkubwira.
So when you hear this background that I'm telling you, you'll be able to know where I want you to go to.
Urumva barababariwe.
So they were forgiven.
Abona abacika cumu basigaye baragarutse.
So now there were survivors who came back.
Barubaka ku gihe cya Zerubabeli.
And they were building at the time of Zerubbabel.
Abahanuzi Hagayi, abahanuzi Zakariya barabahanurira bakabakomeza amaboko.
So the prophets like Haggai and Zechariah would prophesy to them to strengthen them.
Malachi yunguye ibintu Imana imubwiye kubabwira.
Now what God is speaking to Malachi to transmit to the Israelites.
Ubutumwa bwa gubusomye burakubwira eta uko bya.
So actually when you read the message you are able to see how the situation
was.
So they were no longer bound by idols. When I'm talking about Malachi and Israelites, I'm actually talking to you. So align yourself with this. So there are idols that were no longer worshiping. Now this is what they did when they were coming from their captivity. So they married Gentiles. And now they mixed again themselves. So now the holy people, children of God, they mix themselves with what is not holy. Now the sacrifice that they would give, the sacrifices that would bring to God, they were defiled. Now whose mistake was that? Their leaders. So the priest at that time,
they
didn't give much care to see whether the sacrifice they were going to give was blameless or without blemish. So which means that the priest, the servantship or serving God, coming before God, it had just become a ritual and they were no longer fearing God. And God will look at that from heaven.
Yes,
that's Jesus indeed. To the point, and even the animals that were blind or who had
a disability.
Because in the Old Testament, such a type of sacrifice was not supposed to be given. May the Holy Spirit reveal to you what it means in your life. Because there's a sacrifice which was not acceptable. But they didn't care. So they'll just bring them. So now God looked at that.
Yes, ashimwe.
Praise Jesus.
Barangije bagafata maturo.
Now they will take the offerings.
Apani bitambo by'inyamaswa noneho amaturo bazanaga.
Not the sacrifices of animals, but
bari
the offerings
bafite,
of the spring.
Bari bafite kwiplenya ko bakenye kandi bihugu bavuye mu byo bimeze neza.
Actually, they were complaining that they were poor when actually the countries they came from were richer.
Ni ukuvuga bareba abanyamahanga cyangwa abataratoranijwe.
Now, when they look at the Gentiles and those who were not chosen,
bagasanga bo bameze neza.
They realized that they were doing well.
Bagasanga bakize.
And they realized that they were wealthy.
Kandi ntibabeshaga ibyo bihugu byari biteye imbere.
And actually, such nations had made
progress. Ibyo byatumaga bavuga ati, "Mana dusabira icy'amaturo uziko dukennye."
Now they will say, "Oh Lord, why do you request us to give you offerings when you are able to see those who are wealthy?" May the Holy Spirit enable you to
understand.
And they will say, "Oh Lord, you should not ask anything." When we look at those countries of Persia and Babylon, they are wealthy. But according to God, that was meaningless. Because God had not chosen those foreign nations. My desire is that the Holy Spirit may be able to make this clear. Comparing yourself with looking at the progress that the
nations
have
made.
What other nations have reached? And they'll say, why do you ask us to give you offerings? Because we are poor. Here are those who are wealthy. And that is why you hear in the book of Malachi, the Lord actually accused
him
and say, you even steal me from your offerings. Praise Jesus indeed. So now Malachi was sent to transmit that message. So he said that message. And then he told them that.
He
said, you sit and say, for what use should we serve God? Because he said, those who do not serve God actually are doing better than those who serve him. Is there someone who knows such a language? So God was listening, and God will look at them and he say that it is useless. In other words, you are serving me when you are not willing. You are serving me unwillingly. And that is when he sent this message. He said, I'm able to see that. But in your midst, there are those who honor me. Let's thank Jesus for those who honor
him.
So in each generation, there are remnants who
obey him. And
my desire is that you be part of those who are honoring God. In each season, there are those people who are holding fast on the laws of God. You should not think that everyone is just foolish. There are remnants who will continue to obey God. Now the Lord spoke to them. And he says, Malachi, go and speak to them. They should not think that everyone is in that way. There are those who honor me. Even though times are difficult, there are those who are still obeying me. And now those people, even when they speak to one another, I'm able to listen to them. I'm able to see them. They still have hope. They still have hope. Even though times are hard, but they still have hope. And they are still speaking one another, encouraging words. They are continuing to encourage one another. They are still talking about songs in Zion. So they are people. So when they are having a conversation, I record. So please clap your hands. If there's something that should make you joyful when God knows you,
when so
you should read between the lines, and if you do not have that life, you should
want
to be the righteous, because God knows you. So God told Malachi, I know this. Now those people, there is a day that I'll
come.
There is a day I will be
able
to know them and wait for that day, because I cannot continue to bear with that, so that people are confused about things.
I cannot
continue to be patient when people are confused, those who are wicked and those who are righteous. Oh Lord Jesus, we thank you. So there is God in heaven who is silent but with something. Say, I cannot tolerate this. I will come and I'm going to show those who waited for me. I will show those who were patient in such difficult times. I'll show those who went through the same situation like
what you are in,
but those who are expected. And but on that day, he called it a day, but actually it took 400 years. Actually, we're even that day is still going on.
umunsi wo kugaragaza ubwami bw'Imana.
The day to reveal the kingdom. So there is a day
come,
and it will be a difficult one. Because when I come in these times that you are in,
difference is agaragara.
So the difference will be shown. So now, those who are wicked are going to be trampled upon. Those you confuse and you think they are making progress. Those you look at your reference and you think that is what progress is. I'll show you that you deceive yourself. Brethren, there are things that the Holy Spirit does that you cannot
do. There
are things that the Holy Spirit is able to do. And this is what Malachi was saying. So I will not emphasize on the righteous and the wicked. And the difference between those who serve God and those who do not. He said, when I come, it will be clear.
Yes,
praise Jesus indeed. And he said, before I come, I will send. And this is the core part of the message. I'll send Elijah. Because I need to prepare you first. Because the situation, the way it was, beloved, it was so bad. To a point that if Jesus would have come without John the Baptist to prepare him for his way,
he would kill people.
So please hear the love of God. This is the love of God. This is the love of
God.
So now God rebuked them and he appreciated others. But he said this: I cannot just come immediately, but I'll send Elijah. I'll send Elijah. Beloved friends of God, if you are the readers of the Bible, you know that Elijah had already lived before. Because he had lived before. He was a prophet who lived at the time of Israel. And one day he stood and said, it is over for you to go left and right. If the Lord is the Lord, please follow him. And if Baal and other idols are through God, follow them. So Elijah was used by God to draw the line to distinguish those who are looking for God and those who are not. And said, I will send to you Elijah. So now my message today, it says, it's about this: I'll send to you Elijah. And you need to get a revelation of Elijah in your life.
Matthew 11.
We're going to read in Matthew chapter 11. Who is Elijah today? So that you are able to know who you are and where we are heading to today. So I gave a few passages.
Yesu asubiza abamubaza. Ati uwo niwe wandikiwe ngo dore ndenda gutuma integuza yanjye imbere yawe ikakubanziriza igutunganirize inzira. Ndababwira ukuri yuko mu babyawe n'abagore hatigeze kubaho umuntu uruta Yohana Umubatiza, ariko umuto mu bwami bwo mu ijuru aramuruta. Uhereye ku gihe cya Yohana Umubatiza ukageza none ubwami bwo mu ijuru buratwaranirwa, intwarane zibugishamo imbaraga, kuko abahanuzi bose n'amategeko bahanuye kugeza igihe cya Yohana, kandi niba mubishaka kubyemera. Yohana Umubatiza niwe Eliya wahanuwe ko azaza. Ufite amatwi yumva niyumve mera Yesu amashyi.
For this is he of whom it is written, behold, I sent a messenger before your face, who will prepare your way before you. Assuredly, I say to you, among those born of women, there has no risen no greater than John the Baptist, but he who is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. And from the day of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. For all the prophets and the law prophesied until John, and if you are willing to receive it, he is Elijah who is to come. He who has ear to hear, let him hear.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise Jesus.
Yohana umubatiza.
Now John the Baptist,
yari we ntumwa ibanziriza Yesu.
He was the messenger who coming before Jesus.
Yari we ntumwa ije muri yakawo kugira ngo abanziriza abantu.
So he was the messenger who came in the curse so that he can come before Jesus.
Areliya.
So being Elijah.
Ari Yohana umubatiza.
Being John the Baptist.
Bo nk'abantu sibo bakomeye.
So they are not the most important as a human.
Ibanga Yesu ariho avuga n'ubutumwa bafite.
Now the secret that Jesus is revealing is the message that they are bringing. The message of preparation. The message that you fear that it is preparing you.
Yes.
The message preceding Jesus. The message preceding power. The message preceding power.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise Jesus.
Mumigambi tumaze kuririmba y'Imana.
So in the plans of God that we are singing
Imana
about,
nyiribihe,
God who is the author of time,
imenyibihe,
he who knows the times,
igendana n'abantu,
he works with people. And he even sends messengers to them
tandukanye.
At different times and
ariko Imana umunezero wayo sukubura abantu.
That the joy of God is not to lose people.
Umunezero w'Imana n'ukukuronka.
But the joy of God is to be able to have you, whichever way.
Nimwumve bari abantu yabibwiye muri Malachi.
Now listen to the people he was speaking to in Malachi.
Mu myaka 400 hari abapfuye.
Now during the 400 years that those who perished.
Ariko ingeso zabo bakaziha abandi.
And then, but their bad habits they'll be transmitted to others.
Kugeza igihe Yohana umubatiza aje.
To the point John the Baptist came.
Niyo mpamvu.
And that is why
Yohana umubatiza aje.
When John the Baptist came.
Ubutumwa bwe bwari mwihane.
So his message was of repentance.
Hallelujah. Ubutumwa bwe bwo muri ubwo butayu muri icyo gihe cy'ubutayu.
So his message during that time of wilderness.
Yari mwihane.
It was repent.
Yes, ashimwe cyane.
Praise Jesus indeed.
Mbere rero yuko dutangira inkuru y'ubwami bw'Imana.
Now before we talk about the kingdom of God.
Kuki mbabwiye ibi?
Why am I telling you all these things?
Noneho reka nisobanure.
So let me explain myself.
Kuki mbabwiye ibi?
Why am I telling you this?
Kuki tujye gutangira kujya tuvuga ubwami bw'Imana?
Why are we going to start talking about the kingdom of God?
Sinshobora gutangira teme yitwa ubwami bw'Imana ntavuzaho buturuka.
So I cannot start the theme talking about the kingdom of God without talking about the background.
Ubwami bw'Imana.
The kingdom of God.
Ubwami bwa Yesu.
The kingdom of Jesus.
Ubuzima Yesu atanga.
The life that Jesus gives.
Ubwami bw'Imana bwicaye muri twe.
The kingdom of God that dwells in us.
Bwaturukagaho hano.
It was coming from that.
Biravuga iki uyu munsi?
So what does it mean today?
Buriya muri 1994.
In 1994,
Abanyarwanda bari imbere barahunze.
Rwandese who were within the country fled.
Abari hanze barinjiye.
And even those who were outside the country entered into the country.
Hari umuntu umwe wavuze ngo buryo abanyarwanda bose barahunze.
There's a person who said actually all the Rwandese
experienced.
At some point they became refugees.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise Jesus.
Nanje aho narindi narimutse.
Myself where I was, I took refuge.
Icyo ngiye kubabwira.
So what I want to tell you.
Ngeze muri uru Rwanda.
When I came back to Rwanda.
Mu nzira z'Imana.
Through the ways of God.
Nk'umuntu w'Imana.
As a servant of God.
Nk'umukozi w'Imana.
As a servant of God.
Ntushobora kubyiyambura.
You cannot take that away from you.
Kuko gukorera Imana.
Because serving God.
Si ibintu by'ahantu hamwe ngo nugera ahantu ubyiyambura.
It does not depend on where you are.
Umutima wanjye.
But my heart.
Waba gushaka kumenya turi hehe turi kuki.
Was desiring to know where are we, what are we focusing on.
Ariko harimo n'ubuzima privé butari bworoshye butuma nyine nabwo busengera.
And even my private life wasn't easy, so it required a lot of prayer.
Nasanze.
And I realized that
muri uru Rwanda,
in this nation,
hari isezerano.
There is a promise
y'ububyutse muri iki gihugu.
Of revival in this nation.
Ninde wigeze kubyumva?
Who heard this?
Oya ni muzamure neza.
Please raise your hands.
Uzi neza ko hari ububyutse bugomba kuba muri uru Rwanda.
Who is convinced that there should be revival in Rwanda?
Nanjye ndimo.
I'm also included.
Yes, Ashimwe.
Praise Jesus.
Nta nubwo ububyutse mbwumva bwa mbere.
Actually when I heard about revival for the first time.
Sinabwumvise ari uko ngeze mu Rwanda.
Actually I did not hear it when I was in Rwanda.
Muri 1994.
In 1994.
Umupasteri wanjye yarambwiye ngo yigeze kujya gukora igiterane ahantu hitwa Kalemi.
My pastor told me that he organized a conference in a place called Kalemi.
Ngo bahurirayo n'abantu baririmba indirimbo z'inyarwanda bitwa abasaruzi barabadive.
And they met with some singers who were singing Kinyarwanda songs.
Ngo Imana irababwira.
And then God spoke to them.
Ngo akwagahugu gatoya ngo kabo baririmbyi zakagenderera.
And God said that tiny country of those singers is going to visit that nation.
Buretse gato.
So hold on.
No, nese ko mukomye amashyi ugira ngo hari cyo byari bimbwiye.
So now as you clap your hands, do you think that it meant a lot to me?
Icyo nshaka kukubwira.
So what I want to tell you.
Umuntu w'Imana ashobora kukubwira ibintu kabitaho.
A servant of God can tell you things and then just leave them
there.
But by the grace of God, the Holy Spirit will remind you something that was spoken to you. Tell your neighbor, the Holy Spirit, he keeps the information. So when he told me that, he told me about that because of genocide that happened when I was
young.
And he said, even though this is how the situation is, God at some point told us that he will visit your nation. Now, I don't know about what had just happened. But when we were praying for that conference, God led us to that country. So now, when I reach in this country,
Iman,
God revealed to me things. Please remember when I tell you the vision of Omega, we did not come to Rwanda willingly. But it's because one day God went to
Pastor Tai.
Go back to the nation where you were born, that is where I'll do good to you. Go back to your nation where you were born, that is where I'll do good to you. So now the same God that spoke to him came to me. When God wants to convince
you,
so he heard that voice when he was in a hotel in Netherlands. When God wants to convince you about something important, he does something unusual. The problem is because we are stubborn. When you get used, God doesn't have to shake so many things. And also God did something to me. So he visited me at 10 a.m. in the morning. I myself are prophesied for myself. So I prayed in tongues. And then I heard the voice of the Lord. I have never experienced that again. Emphasize that it was for the first time that I was able to interpret the tongues. Even tongues for another one. Because interpreting tongues, it is a gift. So long time ago in 1989,
we
would have prayers where I used to live as a young lady. So we'll start from Thursday evening and complete the prayers on Saturday. So one time,
Pastor Wange,
my pastor, he prayed. He kept on praying. Now he started speaking in tongues. So when he would raise his voice, so when he goes down, I would go down. So now at the end, those who were seated, and even some people actually
came
be my witnesses, the ones
who say,
they said you were interpreting what the pastor was saying. Did it happen again to my life? Now, should I say that I have a gift of interpreting tongues? This is not what I'm saying. What I want to teach you, God does in a way that pleases him. God does what pleases him. Now things pertaining to God, it is according to his will.
Yes,
praise Jesus. So the good thing, the words that he spoke to me when I was in Mombasa, I know them very well. Now that revival, it came in what God has spoken to me. So in the next century to come,
abanyarwanda bazaba abakozi banje.
Rwandans are going to be my servants.
Simpara mbibabwira aha.
Don't I tell you this often? So what I want to tell you.
Sinatinze twaratashye kuko ubwo yari yatwemeje.
Actually I did not delay because I had been convinced by God to go back to our nation. So I went to Nkurunziza. So at that place at noon,
there
we had gatherings.
Ashushi.
And we really had a great
time. That.
Brethren, if you had seen God visiting people, there is no way we would not have said this is a revival. So all of us who had experienced that,
we
are saying here is the revival that God told us. Amen. So can I tell you? There are times because of fear, fear may lead people to pray. So what about you? Are you sometimes not led by God to seek God because of fear? So in 1994,
1995, 96,
even to 2000 when people were saying it is the end of the world, in Rwanda, there is no one who is not praying. Now, take
a
now, at the end of the year 2000, so the world did not come to an end. And you are also witnesses of this. So did the world come to an end? The world is still there. So they prophesied a war. But God protected us. So as we kept on moving forward, what was called revival, it appeared that it was a mixture of things. Fear, poverty, taking houses by force. And and even some people even take wives by force, like the Gentiles that I mentioned in Malachi. Why are you angry? Don't you know men who forsook the wives they had abroad? So what was called revival? Slowly. It appeared that it was a mixture of so many reasons. So what happened next? So the one who was hungry started eating. The thief continued to steal. The one who back in the world did it. The one who was lying, they kept on lying. Now, the God that was supposed to come delayed. Do you remember when Moses climbed the mountain and the Israelites laid to Aaron, see him? Do you remember what they told Aaron? They told him, so the one who took us from Egypt has delayed. So let us create or make. Let us make for ourselves. When God delays in your life, you create your own things.
Uyu munsi.
Today,
there
are people who say because there are many churches in Rwanda, there is revival. Brethren, this is not true. This is not true. Actually, when you see, don't you see that sins are increasing? Who agrees with me?
Yes.
May God bless you. Sins are increasing. So sins are increasing outside. Even people in the house of God are daring to sin.
No, ne, niba dushaka kugendana n'Imana, dukomeze twibeshye ngo ubutuba mu gihe cy'ububyutse.
So now, if you want to continue to work with the God, should we deceive ourselves that we are in a time of revival?
No.
Revival will be seen in this
time.
But let us not deceive ourselves that revival is what we are able to see now. No. So God is visiting each person individually. And God is giving good times to each person. There are those who are seeing God in their specific
life.
But there are also others who are deceiving themselves that God is that look
on
them. So if you want to walk with God this year, so I want you to have thirst and hunger. Salvation is not what you are seeing currently. Salvation is not confessing, say, I receive Jesus, and then you continue to live the same old life. So if you allow this, you pray with
intention.
So God told Malachi that I'll make a difference in
the difference.
It is important that the Spirit shows the difference. So let's have hunger and thirst for a Spirit that makes a difference. Let people be grieved and say, your kingdom has come in our midst, but it needs to be shown. Let's pray and say, oh Lord, those who speak for your name, let them get rid of
our...
So let's not continue to repair things and think that revival has come. So when you are fed up with that, you'll stop comparing yourself with those who
did
that. So the French say in the kingdom of blind people, the one who has one eye, they think that so we need to have that thirst and hunger for the kingdom of God as we start talking about this topic. And you should not point your finger to someone else. So let's all of us search for ourselves and say, oh Lord, where are you? And even the signs and the wonders that you perform. So now in Matthew chapter 3, now you start reading in English. So for those who have Bibles in English, please read in Matthew chapter 3 from 1 to 2 and Matthew chapter 4 from 15 to
17.
So let's read. Now if you have thirst and hunger for God, so I kindly request you have thirst and hunger to see God. If you have thirst and hunger to have a job, you should all have the same thirst for the one who gives the job. Look for the one who gives the job. Let's arise and look for the one who gives all those things that we are looking for. Let's look for the owner of all those things. Then we are going to be the light of the world. Otherwise, it will be just mere words and theology.
Ngicyo giye Yohana Umubatiza araza yigishiriza mu butayu bw'Yudaya ati mwihane kuko ubwami bwo mwijuru buri hafi. Ijambo mwihane rica wagarongo.
Emphasize the word repent.
Matayo kane.
Matthew chapter 4.
Umve na Yesu.
So listen to what Jesus said.
Mu gihugu cya Zebuloni na Neftali hari fi y'inyanja hakurya ya Yorodani ni Galilaya y'abapagani. Abantu bari bicaye he mu mwijima babonye umucyo mwinshi. Kandi abari bicaye mu gihugu cy'urupfu no mu gicucu cyarwo bamurikirwa n'umucyo. Yesu aheraho atangira kwigisha avuga ati, Yesu aratangiye kwigisha atangirira he? Mwihane kuko ubwami bwo mu ijuru buri hafi mera Yesu amashyi.
Repent for the kingdom of God is at hand. Give a hand clap to Jesus.
Yesu yararangije aravuga sinkotinga ibyanditswe byinshi.
I'm not quoting so many scriptures.
Ngubu butumwa bw'ubwami bugomba kuvugwa kugeza ku mpera y'isi.
So Jesus said this message of the kingdom of God is supposed to be announced to the all the ends of the earth.
Habundi butumwa ushobora kumva.
There is no other message that you can listen to. Because all the message should lead you to repentance.
Nta nubwo bigombera kumwigisha kubwire ngo ihane.
And actually, even the teacher is not supposed to tell you repent.
Ubutumwa bw'ubwami buraza mu mutima wawe iteka ntabwo buze kukubwira ibyo ugiye kubona gusa.
The message of the kingdom of God, when it comes, does not tell you only the things you're going to receive.
Ibintu bigomba kujya mu mwanya.
It tells you the things you're supposed to put in order.
Yohana yagaragaye avuga ngo mwihane.
So now John was revealed saying, please repent.
Yesu yateguriraga mwenye waraza atangiye kwigisha atangira ati nimwihane.
And even Jesus, he was preparing for when he came, the first thing he said, repent.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise Jesus.
Nimumbabarire mumbwire abo bahanuzi babiri.
Now, if we consider the two prophets,
bahawe kuvuga,
if they were given the opportunity to
speak, ubu ngubu hari ibintu bigiye kuba byiza.
And they say now there are good things that are going to happen.
Yes, kuko ubwami bw'Imana bwari buzanye amahoro ateye ubwoba.
Yes, because the kingdom of God was
bringing peace in abundance.
But there was no other message but of repentance. So I want to tell you this.
Igihe cyose Imana igiye kukugirira neza.
So whenever God wants to do good to you,
izakuyobora kwihana.
He will lead you to repent. It is not a human being. I want to repeat this again. You should not repent because of someone. Never repent unto
a man.
The Holy Spirit in the word is enough to lead you to repentance. So, beloved, if there are things you are expecting and have not yet received them, it's because we have the message of kingdom upside down.
Repent.
All the time it will come telling you, repent. It will always tell you the things that you are supposed to put in the right place. So whenever you put things in order, actually you don't even have to ask for a blessing. Because definitely the blessing will follow. Give a hand clap because he said the truth. You need to go home with this. So the secret of a blessing, the secret of a blessing, the secret of a blessing, it is repentance. The message, the gospel, any gospel that actually, you do not need a teacher and what you are reading to tell you to repent. Actually, a person may tell you repent, you ask
repent.
But the Holy Spirit in this book, every message that is going to tell
you,
it will always leave you with something to repent for. So whenever you depart from a place where the gospel is shared, the gospel of the kingdom, and you realize that you don't have something to repent of. You should not boast and say that you are righteous. It is
impossible.
Because the Holy Spirit have a responsibility to sanctify us to the day we are going to leave this body. So put aside sin. Remove a mistake. If you are helped by the Holy Spirit, if you are not just helped by the letter, and see that all the promises one by one are going to happen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Are we still walking together? So let's walk together with God. When you take time for prayer, you should be a Christian of the kingdom and say, oh Lord, what do you want from me? What do you expect from me? Sometimes not require you to think. Put aside what is wicked. Then God will fulfill what he has promised to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now for those who are ready, I talked about them
recently.
Do you know that when the kingdom of God came, he found survivors of the time of the wilderness? So I want to tell you, even though we look for a revival, even in the spiritual realm,
the times are hard. inzira zima.
Even though those called Christians and some of the world have distorted the
abantu bagitegereje Imana.
There are people, remnants, who are
abantu bataryarya mu mitima yabo bavuga ati ndakenye ariko ndagutegereje.
There are people who are not hypocrite in their hearts who can say I'm sick, I'm waiting for you. Even though I'm grieved in my heart, but I'm waiting for you. I'm lacking this or that, but I'm still waiting for you, my Lord. I pray that you'll be part of that group. I pray that your prayers should not be comprised of the things you are requesting for, but belong
to God.
And then the year 2020 to be a year where you move from glory to glory.
Shaka iman.
So search for God.
Shaka umwuka w'Imana.
Seek for the Spirit of God.
Ibizubura biraza kuza.
Now the things that you are lacking, they will come.
Abiteguye kwakira Imana.
Now for those who are ready to
mutega
receive God.
Gusa isahira mbababwire.
Please hear who they are.
Reka mpere kuri Maria.
So I'm going to start from Mary.
Maria avuga mu ndirimbo.
Mary, when she was singing,
ashima Imana.
She was thanking God in a song.
Aravuga ati ndagushimira.
And he said, I thank you.
Ati imbabazi z'Imana ziri kuba mwubaha.
And he said, the mercy of God is upon those who obey him.
Ati kandi ibyo bizaba uko ibihe bizaha ibindi.
And this will happen as generation comes another.
Atuzi ko anyaza abakomeye intebe zabo.
And even the thrones of the powerful.
Ashize hejuru aboroheje.
Now he has lifted up those who are humble.
Abasonze yibye arabahagije.
Those who have thirst for things concerning him.
Naho abakire batabishaka.
Now those who are wealthy but who are not looking for things, he's bidding farewell to them empty-handed. Are you getting something from this? Have thirst and hunger to know God.
Maria ntiyarazwi.
Because Mary was not known. But when the kingdom of God came, and she was chosen to be pregnant of Jesus.
Maria yari mu bakobwa bategereje.
And she was part of the ladies.
Maria yarafite isezerano ryo guhera mu isezerano rya cyangwa Mesiya zaza.
She had a promise in the Old Testament that the Messiah will come.
Niba uri mu bashaka ububyutse.
So if you are part of those who are looking for revival,
uzabuba mute.
How are you going to be part of it? Are you working for it? So what I want to tell you as I stand here, that promise, you will see it, and even in this great
election.
But who is it going to walk? Who will be the survivor of this time of cunning? In this time where there are so many deceitful things that are taking place in the world. When there are things deceiving us, those other people not saved, why are they doing this? Now, because obedience to God has decreased. So brethren, I have a responsibility to tell you that if I'm a pastor, actually I'm scared. I'm scared to see the way things that the people are supposed to believe in are on the decline. So let's come back to God like the time of Malachi. Let's come back to God. Please come back to God in 2020.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise Jesus.
Uwo yari Maria.
Now, this was Mary.
Zachariah aravuga ati se wa Yohana Umubatiza.
Zechariah, the Baptist. So he was filled with the Holy Spirit. And then he prophesied saying,
Umwami Imana himbazwe.
He said, may the Lord be praised.
Ariwe Mana ya Israel.
Who is God of Israel?
Igendereye abantu ngo ibacungure.
Who visited the people to redeem.
Kandi bizibikoze nkuko yabihanuye kuva kera mu kanwa k'abahanuzi bayo.
And he's fulfilling this based on how he prophesied in the month of prophets. And he said, when we are survived from the enemies, from
enemy,
we are going to serve God with boldness. Brethren, when the things I'm telling you, I'm not putting them far from
you.
I'm telling the things that will happen in the time of revival. And the power that God is going to pour during the time of revival. Who can tell me me if it's not tomorrow. But the secret is to prepare your heart. Have a heart that is willing. A heart that is seeking God. You should not be like the Pharisees and Sadducees. Because John the Baptist saw them also coming to be baptized. Because he was a furious person. Actually, he was not a diplomatic. Now, those were prominent people at that time. And then he said, "You sons of vipers, are you also coming? You have also heard this thing. Who has warned you? Who has told you to escape the wrath that is about to happen?" And he said, this is what you are thinking about. You think that it's just about coming and be baptized?
No.
I said, no.
No.
No. If you are repenting, you should bear fruits of those who have repented. You should not continue to say that these things have just come. We are the sons of Abraham. So now when John was led by the Holy Spirit, at that time, he said, "You should not scare me because of your position. Bear fruits of those who are righteous." And I'm also telling you this message. And I'm telling everyone who is listening to me, the things that we boast about are saying we long time ago, or say this was my position or this. So now these were boasting because they are the sons of Abraham. And he said those things you are boasting about, put them aside. Put aside your positions and
rights.
If you have repented, you are going to see this based on the fruits you are going to bear. And he said, if you are boasting that you are the sons of Abraham, God can even turn these stones into the children of Abraham. So it was a time that was and God had prophesied that. So there's a time that you're not supposed because even the little things that you're joking with are going to be exposed. My desire is to hear what is
inside.
You're going to see this. What is happening in secret? One by one, by the love of God, it is going to be exposed. It is going to be exposed. It is going to be exposed. So you should not say, "I'm just a member of Omega," or "I give the tithe and the offering." But if you are not being transformed, if the message of repentance does not touch your heart, if it does not make you tremble, you are being religious. You are religious. You just come in and get out. You are continuing your old ways. You are not changing anything. And nothing scares you. And nothing touches your heart. But this is not the kingdom of God. Because the light and darkness cannot be together. The light cannot come and be together with darkness. When the light has come, so the darkness goes away. Now here's another group. Now the people of Zebulun, actually they were living in darkness. So but at the time of revival, you'll be surprised to see pagans running to the church compared to those who have been in the house of God. My desire is that you may receive what I'm telling. Actually, it will make jealous those who will have been in the church. Now, those who were in the shadow of death, they were illuminated. And then they responded. So let me tell you, time has come. God is going to expose those who serve him and those who do not. Let me tell you also about Simeon. He was an old man who feared God. To think about this, there are people who are not known in the house of God. Who are not known. who are keeping promises on themselves. There's a person who said, even though I'm old, but I want to see that revival when it comes. Now, Simeon saw Jesus. And he said, here is the
promise.
He said, now salvation has come. And I was waiting for it. And say, now you can bid farewell to me because
I
have thirst and anger to see God in your life. You should not be satisfied with the way you
are.
So let me conclude talking about the old woman.
She
lived with her husband for 7 years. Now she was 87 years old. So she spent more than 80 years. So she would pray and fast, waiting for salvation of Israel. Now when she went to the temple to pray, the Holy Spirit convinced her that was the fulfillment of
her.
So there are people who are waiting for God. There are people who are waiting for there are people who are saying salvation is not what we are seeing. People should be saved. People should be filled with the Holy Spirit. People should fear sin. People should be honest with one another. People should be honest with one another. People should be changed and it should be visible. So you and I, we should have that. So such things should also come to you. Now the Samaritan woman. You know her? I want to tell you, when the times of revival have
come,
even the adulterers, they are able to be enlightened. So the woman was arguing, but there's one good thing that she had. She said, I know that the Messiah will come. There is something that I'm waiting for. Even though I'm tired, even though I had such difficult
times,
but I'm keeping a promise. I'm also expectant. The Messiah will come. And
we
were told that when he comes, everything will be clear. And Jesus told her, I am the one.
Hallelujah.
My desire is that Messiah may visit you today and tell you have been religious for too long, but I have come. My desire is that the life of kingdom may work in
you.
My desire, the kingdom of God, may be like a seed, a small seed that becomes a big tree. Because we do not receive the kingdom of God, but I'm encouraging you today to refresh that life in you. Call upon God and say, rescue me from the things that are suffocating you in
me.
Let me experience your power. And so that your deeds may be visible. We sang, say it. Let's sing together. Let your kingdom come, let your will be done. Come and refresh our
hearts.
Come and refresh our bodies. Come and heal. So let's be all saved. Do you want to walk with God?
Benedict.
Brethren, now the words that I have just spoken to you, I'm not a prophet. But I'm a prophet of God by the grace of God when it goes through the word of God.
Muzabibon.
You're going to see this with your own eyes. There is nothing else that the Holy Spirit is telling me now. We should prepare ourselves to receive the power that God is going to pour on those who are waiting for Him. You should not wait for things. You should not talk about possessions. But be grieved by the owner. Be grieved because of the owner of the thing. And even us who serve God, we should not boast and say we are so much busy in your work. But you should have thirst and anger for the kingdom of God. So serve the kingdom and think for the kingdom. Now imagine, why did Jesus Christ sacrifice himself because of you? So please stand up so that we can pray. Put your hand on your heart.
Ngami mana mu izina rya Yesu turi imbere yawe muri twe harimo abakwakiriye Yesu umucyo wa uvira muri twe uramurika cyane turahembuka turakira tuvuga nka Zakariya ngo tubonye imbaraga zo gukora dushize ubwoba twigaranzuye abari baradutwaje igitugu mwami muri twe harimo abamurikiwe n'umucyo banezerwa kanya gato ubundi bisubirira mu nzira y'Egiputa muri twe harimo abatanazi uwo mucyo bakibereye muri wa mwijima nk'uwa Zabuloni na Neftali bakirimo mwijima bagitwaje igitugu na Satani agitegeka inzira zose z'umwijima bakamukurikira bayobe uko bazavayo muri twe harimo abafite intege nke ariko bagutegereje mwami wanjye ndagusaba ngo abo bose twese tumenye ndagusaba ngo ntabwo bigombera ko nguhata amagambo ndakwinginga mu izina rya Yesu girira buri wese ukubona ubukene bwe bumeze uri mu gicucu cy'urupfu umusango mumurikire ngo nawe yamurikikiwe n'umucyo umugereho abyumve mana uwamurikiwe n'umucyo akisubirira Egiputa nta wundi muntu wabimwemeza kuko ashobora kuba nawe atarabizi mwuka wera gira uwubwira ngo wasubiye mu Egiputa kungira uramfite ariko wisubiriye mu Egiputa ubuzima bwawe nta ubutaniye nubwo abatanze mugirire neza uwo na wagaruke ahimbaza izina ryawe mwami uwakwatuye nk'umwami n'umukiza uyu munsi akaba arambiwe akaba avuga ati nabonye umucyo ariko ndarambiwe gutegereza ndarambiwe ncitse intege mwami uwo mugenere ubuntu bukwiriye umunsi muhagarika umukomeze mwambika imbaraga ariko ndagusaba ngo umutere gushaka gusa n'ushaka mushyiremo ubushake mwami mwuka wera ni wowe ibyo bintu zikubikora mwami hari abagutegereje mu mbaraga nke zabo nka Mariya mwami mu mbaraga nke bisuzugura baraho ariko bavuga bati ibyo ari byo byose hari ibihe dutegereje abo nabo bahumurize ubambika imbaraga zo gukomeza gutegereza mwami nyemerera nkwereke u Rwanda abanyarwanda ibihugu by'ibiyaga bigari mwami abo bantu bose aho hantu buri wese umubajira kubwira ati dutegereje ububyutse nyamara nzi ngo ubwo bubyutse aho buzazira ni wowe uzabuza mu mbaraga zawe mwami ububyutse en soi si kamara ariko icyiza cy'ububyutse no kuhindura ibintu uhindura imitima ugahindura societe ugahindura ibihugu ugahindura ingo ugahindura ahantu ugahindura abantu amahoro akagwira akaba menshi abakugarukira bakaba benshi ndagusaba mu izina rya Yesu nziko mu buhanga bwa ufite kubigenza ndagusaba ngo twambika imbaraga kandi tebuka tebuka turagushaka komeza uhembere imitima yacu twambike kugutegereza twihanganye ariko mwami uze nawe ntutindi wigeze kuvuga ngo kukuzaho ntazatinda zaza garagara mwami ukore difference abagukorera n'abatagukorera bigaragare abagukunda n'abatagukunda bigaragare abapagani n'abakwizera batandukane bigaragare mwami uhembe bigaragare mwami umucyo n'umwijima bitandukane pe kugeza igihuri mu mwijima amenye ngo nibera mu mwijima uri mu mucyo avuga ati bariya bari mu mwijima ndakwinginga mu izina ryawe rigera Yesu kubwo murava n'imbabazi zawe icyampa ngo ubikore tukuragije rero wa mwaka tumaze iminsi tukubwira soko uyu mwaka uzaburangije byose ariko ngwino ibiri ku mutima bisohore ngwino usohoza amasezerano ushima ushaka ariko cyano dutere inzara n'inyota y'ibya ni mu izina rya Yesu mbisabye nizeye amen imana ibahumugisha
may God bless you.